What's good, guys? It's a boy, young boy Beats. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, do not forget to smash the subscribe button. Do you know that beat mixing and mastering is very important? So if you want to learn, stay tuned. Let's just start. So this is the beat, guys. So I'm going to show you exactly ways how to come up with this clean type of beat. So let me go to my plugins one by one. So first, if you want to mix this piano, first thing, I used EQ to cut the lows because I don't need unnecessary lows to the piano, so that it will ruin our bass line. I just cut the unnecessary lows, and then I boosted some presence. So it will be like raw like this. Then now it's sounding smooth. And then I add a bit of reverb. So this is fruit reverb too. It's depend on how much you want to be big your reverb and the amount. So that's dope like this. Next thing, I need to change this sound using hardcore. This is an inbuilt plugin in FL Studio. So I put the preset code acid rock. It got delay, reverb, modulator, flanger, a chorus. So if you just put this preset, you just add it on your own. If you don't need much flanger, you have to reduce, or a chorus. And then delay. Then you can. So that's dope. Next, to come up with this type of e-bass, I just closed the highs and the lows. I just left with the mids here, the low mids. Reverb, it's turned off. Let's remove it. And then I cut the lows again, and I cut the part where I boosted sometime, this part. I just need to add some presence. Okay. And then mouth bend compressor. I just played with the mid bend ratio. It's 1.2 threshold -22.7, and then knee, it's 47%, attack to 26.8 milliseconds, release it's 100 ms, gain it's 7.1. So next thing, the guitar. If you want to mix this type of guitar, you have to use this infected mushroom from Waves plugins. This plugin is dope, guys. So I removed the lows because I don't need the lows to the guitar. So I just add some magic. And then the highs, input, board, or a push. And here you can add punch, or you can make your guitar sound wide how you want, using this stereo imager. And then I cut the lows. grab again, as I told you. Next thing for this feather, I cut the highs, the treble, and I cut the sub and bass. I add reverb to make it wide, so use the stereo shaper, and then I add some chorus to make it go around my headphones to add some flying effect. This is our bass line. Have a beautiful bass line. First, you have to separate your stereo separation here to 55 or 50 in number you want, and then I cut all the highs, the presence, and the mids to the bass line. I just need the real bass line, that's why I boosted here. And then Smack Attack, it got some amazing presets in it. So just put bass small fingers, and then I adjust to myself. I don't need my bass to clip. So it's to make your bass line sound bigger and heavy. Then I just choose this guitar. Plugin from Waves again. I just put here to bass, then here just ignore the microphone and everything. So you choose type of the bass line you want. This one is cool. So for the guitar melody, use hardcore, you put equalizer first and reverb. So added too much high, mid, and treble. I cut the lows. I don't need the lows. I add some reverb. And then this Smack Attack again. I go to the presets. Just put the muted or acoustic or funky guitar. Watch one engine, you can adjust yourself. Sustain minus 23, attack 25, and then duration this shape. Output to minus 2.1, then here to limit. So for my percussion, I just use first for this percussion, I cut the lows. Because this is the percussion, I need to clean my percussion. I just left with mids and then a high mid presence and treble. And I add a bit of reverb. I didn't add much reverb because I don't want my percussion to sound noise as I cleaned it first here. And then for my kick, use this Smack Attack, the sustain to minus 9, attack to 3, then output to 2.0. And then I cut the mids, the presence, and then I just maintain the sub here, as you see, the sub. So just maintain the sub for it to sound amazing. For the conga, I use Smack Attack, sustain to 7, and attack to minus 7, output to 0. So this plugin called Smack Attack, it's good for percussion or for mixing the beat, guys. It's top. And then last thing for this acoustic, to come up with this type of acoustic, this is from Contact, but it's just sounding like real guitar. I removed the unwanted frequencies, and then I cut the lows. I put another EQ to maintain the shape for the this EQ is to clean this part, and then I just cut the lows again, and then I boosted a bit, then I remove my unwanted frequencies to make it sound like real acoustic, and then I add fruit delay to add delay. So that's all for beat mixing. Let's go to the final mix. First thing, I don't need my beat to clip, so I use this soft clipper. The threshold I put to 00, then post to 80%. I need to make it loud a bit, so I put gain for this fruit limiter, and then I put some saturation. Then last thing, this is the eye pusher to maintain the shape, the sound, the tone for the beat. So this plugin is dope, guys. You can just deal with the highs, mids, lows and everything, and then you can make your beat wide again in one plugin, guys. So this plugin is dope. So guys, that's how to mix and master Afrobeats in FL Studio. See you again next time. Don't forget to like, subscribe and comment.